Hello! In this quick movie, I'm going to be introducing you to quadratic equations and the general form of a quadratic equation. So, first of all, what is a quadratic equation? A quadratic equation in one variable is an equation in which the greatest exponent of the variable is 2, as in 6x square minus x minus 2 equal to 0 and y square minus 5y plus 4 equal to 0. This equation is in variable x and x is the only variable present here. Similarly, this equation is in variable y and y is the only variable here. You probably have already seen a pattern here. Number times variable squared plus or minus number times the same variable plus or minus number equal to 0. Mathematicians call this pattern the general form, which is formally written as ax square plus bx plus c equal to 0. If you compare the general form with the pattern that we just came up with, you should be able to see that they have used x in place of variable, which is not necessary. Y is also fine. That is why I chose example 2 to be in variable y. You will also find z's, w's, p's and q's. But x is used more frequently than the others. Okay, now that these two are out of the way, let's focus on a, b, and c. Again, if you compare it with this pattern, you should see that a, b, and c are in places of numbers. So, x is a variable. A, b, and c are numbers, more precisely, real numbers. But there is an exception. A should not be equal to 0. We'll see why a cannot be equal to 0 in this very movie. I know you have already understood this, but just so that all of us are on the same page, let me make it clear. This means b equal to 0 is fine, c equal to 0 is also fine, and even if both of those are equal to 0, that is still fine. By now, you probably have a question. In example 1, there are negative signs here, but the general form has only positives. How come? If you had this question, brilliant, but if you did not, I hope now you do. And my answer is, you will understand the reason as soon as we complete this simple exercise. Let us focus on the first one for now. It says, create a quadratic equation in variable x with a equal to 1, b equal to 2, and c equal to 3. So let's bring the general form here. Since the variable is supposed to be x, these two are just fine. A is supposed to be 1, so let's switch that out. B is supposed to be 2, and C is supposed to be 3. And, well, that is the final answer. No, wait. Mathematicians prefer to not write 1 as a coefficient, so let's drop that out. Now, let's move on to the next exercise, which says, create a quadratic equation in variable alpha with A equal to phi, b equal to 0 and c equal to negative 25. If you do not know what alpha is, it is a Greek alphabet which is used as a variable in mathematics and other sciences. You don't need to worry much about it. Also here, b is equal to 0, but that is alright. Now, let's bring the general form. So, the variable is supposed to be alpha. Let's switch that. A is 5. And b is 0 and c is negative 25. 0 times alpha is 0, so that disappears. And we have 5 alpha squared minus 25 equal to 0. We can simplify it further by dividing it by 5. So we have alpha squared minus 5 equal to 0. Okay, by now you probably have figured out the reason why there is no negative in the general form. But I'm gonna tell it to you. Look at this equation, there is a negative here. But it came from c because c is negative 25. So if you think of it in a reverse manner, you should have the answer. The general form has only positive signs because negatives come from a, b and c. Okay, now let's see why a should not be equal to 0. And between you and me, the best way to understand that is by equating it to 0. So let's reconsider this equation and instead of a equal to 1, we'll use a equal to 0. Now, 0 times x squared is 0, so it disappears. And we are left with 2x plus 3 equal to 0. And this equation is not quadratic. You probably can recognize this as a linear equation in one variable. So the conclusion, at a equal to 0, quadratic equations change to linear equations. Therefore, we have this here. So that about wraps up this movie. Check out the links in the description and please do the YouTube thing. Smash the thumbs up button if this was helpful or the thumbs down otherwise. Share it with others and let me know your thoughts or questions in the comments. In the next movie, we will discuss the zero product principle and more. And as always, thanks for watching.